out with K TIG, for instance, I know we get back to pre-processing. I still believe it's one of the most important things in welding. Everything before the welder touches it, so much can go right or wrong from ordering, right? Material, like buyers buying, bringing material in.
I say you can grind before or you can grind after.
Grind before. Yeah. I know one of the things that people say about K-TIG is, yeah, it's put that fit up. Get that fit up right. And we talked about sealing passes and buttering joints before you weld them. In the beginning, did you guys struggle? Tell me, like, the good, the bad, the ugly about K-TIG. Look, people want to know.
When we first started, it's just like it says, you know, I tried everything in one pass. We learned quickly, you know, the fit up on them bigger heads, the shells, you know, we can fit cylinder to cylinder. We quit beveling everything. So there's more than one thing that can upgrade to. So we don't bevel any heads. We don't bevel any shells anymore. It's a square edge up to half inch. So what that's allowing us to do is the better the fit up, the better it is. But we actually run two passes. We'll run a straight root pass, and then I'll run a pulse pass on a cover. It's about the same time as a cold wire feeler, a regular TIG, but it's saving me so many hours on rework, zero, my polishing time, and I'm on my X-raying. So if I don't have any failures, and we electro-polish 90% of our stuff, so that's where we'll take off a layer, and we don't know that that even happens until we get downstream. And if we have one failure, that's going to add immediately 10 more to 20 more hours to fix every hole, because we've got to take it back to weld it, we got to grind it, and we got to respot it. So that's what we're doing.
Has K-TIG created any bottlenecks because of it in your shop or over the years? Did it create a bottle, like it freed up something over here and then you got to fight something?
It didn't for us. You know, our grinders love it because what used to take them 10 hours to grind a head might take them two. So, I mean, it's all been pluses for us on the K-TIG side. And even all the continuous improvements has helped us out. You know, there's a learning curve to everything. You'll figure out, you know, you blow a big hole in the sidewall, you got to fix it. But you try to figure out what caused it, find root cause problems, and eliminate them.